Hello students, today I am going to talk about development of cinema as a medium of mass communication. First, I would explain the concept of communication. Then I would explain how cinema or films is a medium of mass communication. So I have prepared a PPT for you, and from that I'm going to explain. Now, first of all, we need to understand what is communication. Communication is defined as an act of sending or receiving or understanding messages or meanings when delivered from one person to another. So the act of communication or the process of communication has a sender, a medium, and a receiver. A sender who sends a message, a medium through which the message travels, and finally, the receiver who receives the message and interprets. Okay. When communication is defined in relevance to mass media, it can be called as a centralized form of communication. Why centralized form of communication? Because, a particular medium, like for example, radio or television, it is regarded as a medium for the masses. And centralized form of medium because, or centralized form of communication because, a group of people residing in a society understands that message, receives that message. Okay? So through one medium, a lot of people or many people can be informed. So what is mass medium? Mediums of communication for the masses, as I said, that radio, television, internet in today's generation can all be considered as mediums of communication for the masses. In this context, mass refers to the collective people, collective audience, or group of people in a society. Different mediums of communication, such as radio, television, internet, are communicative mediums for transmitting messages to a society. So if a government, okay, wants to impart a message, wants to deliver a message, there are mediums of, television, there are mediums of internet, okay, in today's generation, Twitter is a source of mass communication. Okay, we have our prime minister, we have our minister choosing these mediums to deliver their messages to the society in large. Mass media is a form of media which is addressed for large audience, for a large group of audience, that is the masses. Okay, collective audience, which represents a society. You, me, then the entire community, okay? The community, the people of Bangalore, the people of Kerala, Karnataka, then everyone collectively, okay? All over, the masses, the people spread across India, in every corner, in every state of India. They are the collective people of India. They are the masses of India. It can be any form of media, broadcast such as television, radio, print media, newspaper, magazines, pamphlets, etc. So any medium which is used for a specific purpose or by someone to deliver a message to the society, to a large number of audience, that is mass media. In today's generation, as I said, internet is also a medium of mass communication. Now, communication through mass media is known as mass communication. Mass communication means using a form of mass media to deliver messages immediately to a large group of people, immediately and collectively. It is not that only, when the government speaks, when the prime minister speaks, through a television channel, through a news channel. It is not just that only I am receiving the message. We all are receiving the message. Mass media today has become one of the popular media as it focuses on the prominent stories which will be of interest to the general public audience. Okay, the most important news are delivered through mass media, because those news would impact us collectively. When there was a lockdown, the government chose the medium of mass communication, television, to impart the message of lockdown. So that was a very crucial, important message, and that was broadcasted through television. Now come to how films are a medium of mass communication. Cinema is perhaps the mainstreams of all art forms and most accessed and most preferred, especially in India. So India has a tradition. We as a collective people are very much fond of watching cinema, and cinema is a medium of mass communication because it spreads messages about society collectively to a large number of audience. Cinema can be a form of art, entertainment, social document, or critique. So, it can be a form of art, okay? So, and also entertainment. We watch cinema for entertainment purposes, or maybe, there are some art films which question society, which are a critique of society. Critique means, which criticizes a society or criticizes some laws, some rules, some age-old customs, blind traditions, okay? Film communication is a process of transferring meanings or information through visual receptors. So those messages that we receive are, visual messages, okay? So visually we receive those messages, because cinema is a collection of thousands of images, okay? Film is a reflection of society for both the present and the past. There could be historical films, there could be, films which are a comment, which are a commentary on the society. Film and its innovations sometimes have to catch up to the society, but sometimes it leads the society and culture too. Some films, because of the changing society, changing trends, they have to catch up with the society. As I said that, when we were having the classes, online classes, I told you that, when there are films, based on a reality, that is, the cinematographers, they prefer the audience's taste, okay? The audience's taste has changed. We don't want to see a protagonist, a male protagonist who is very muscular, well-built. We, audiences relate to the relatable, okay? To the practical things of life. So due to the changing society, due to the changing trends, sometimes, films and cinematographers, study that trend and then they modify themselves, then they change themselves. But there are also some films which show a society that it is time to change. It is time to change the superstitious rituals. It is time to change the patriarchal culture. It is time to change or come out from, stereotypical portrayals, okay? Stereotypical notions. Film, as one such form of mass media, has a great impact on the societies in many ways. So films influence societies. Okay, films have the power to influence society because, visually we are receiving the messages. A film directly impacts on our sensibilities, on our emotions. Okay, so that's why films have the power to influence or change a particular society. Today's generation films have handled a lot of controversial topics such as religion, terror attacks, transgender, homosexuality, child labor, poverty, etc. I hope you are aware of the film, for example, Pink, Okay, Pink, the Bollywood film Pink. So Pink talked about the, you know, equality, the, you know, patriarchal culture. Okay, and the culture, the society that acknowledges crimes done by men. Okay, so films have the power to influence a society. Movies have actually brought to the world an idea about all the above through their stories and concepts. But at the same time, they idealize or generalize few things for the profit's sake, and public believes it, and it finally becomes a stereotypical notion or stereotype process. So, you know, sometimes there are films, you know, which portray, you know, the protagonist, the male protagonist is a playboy. He dates many women, and he has a hard time to choose between girls, whom to date, whom to marry. Okay, so these are very stereotypical notions, and sometimes for profit's sake, there are some films which feed on these stereotypical notions. They don't change, they don't want to come out. So, you know, films as a medium of art has the power to change the society, and it is my own personal belief that cinematographers should consider this point, that, you know, a society can only progress if they come out from their stereotypical notions, okay? Next, films are instrument of communication, and all filmmakers are communicators of their thoughts, visions, and ideas. They tell stories through words, not pictures. Okay? So films are instrument of communication, and all out here, let me omit this line, because through pictures, actually a film is made. Yeah, so films are instrument of communication, and all filmmakers are communicators of their thoughts, visions, and ideas. Whatever, you know, if a filmmaker has a progressive thought, has a progressive, unique thought, okay? So, you know, through his or her individual opinions, individual ideas, that filmmaker will have a potential, have the agency to change the society. Communication is an act of exchanging information. It is a social process by which expression of human needs takes place and people influence each other. So, films or cinema as a medium of communication, it is an act of exchange of information. The filmmaker is delivering some information to the audience, and the audience's reaction will be gathered, will be collected, will be observed by the filmmaker. So it is a social process which influences people, which influences each other. Now, this was all about how cinema or films can be considered as a medium of mass communication. Now, let me briefly talk about development of cinema in India as a medium of mass communication. So, the first and foremost Indian film show occurred in 1896, in July 7th, just few months after Lumiere brothers introduced the art of cinematography in 1895 in Paris. The first Indian film made by an Indian was Harish Chandra Bhatyadekar. Okay, so, you know, from the end of 19th century, cinema had come to India through Lumiere brothers. In 1905, the Elphinstone Bioscope Company was established by J.F. Madan, who mainly the first businessman who first envisaged the business opportunity in the film industry in India. Okay, the first Indian feature film was Pundalik, made in 1912. Okay, these are some minute historical details which you can remember. You can learn them. Then Dhundiraj Govind Phalke is known as the father of Indian cinema. And there is a special award under the name of Govind Phalke, that is Dada Sahib Phalke Award. And that award was, you know, set up by the government of India. His debut film was Raja Harishchandra in 1913, and there are some more other feature-length films and short films that he had made. Then gradually we have the, you know, art of cinema and entertainment flourishing as an industry, booming as an industry. You know, some of the names I've mentioned, Kagaz Ke Phool, the Oppu trilogy, Oppu's Sangsar, all these films were very artistic. They were also a critique on society. Then there are some more films, okay, which led the way of commercialization. Okay, so by the end of the 19th century and the beginning of 20th century, the element of love, passion, a girl following her dreams, a boy, getting the woman he loves, became the dominant themes of Indian cinema. And that was actually for profit's sake. So that's all, students. Here are some sources which I have used. I hope you have enjoyed this lecture. Thank you so much.